along, minding my business, when out of an orange colored sky.
Fire! What did the 20s mean to me?
I was humming a tune, drinking in sunshine, went out of that orange colored view. I got a look at you. One look and I yelled, timber, watch out for flying glass. Cause the ceiling fell in and the bottom fell out. I went into a spin, that's why I've been shot, I've been hit.
This is it.
I was walking along, minding my business, when love came and hit me in the eye.
Flash, bam, alakazam.
Out of an orange colored sky. And I yelled, timber, watch out for flying glass. Cause the ceiling fell in and the bottom fell out. I went into a spin, that's why I've been shot, I've been hit.
This is it, I take it.
I was walking along, minding my business, when love came and hit me in the eye. Out of an orange colored purple stripe, pretty green polka dot sky. Alakazam and goodbye. Wow, I thought love was much softer than that. What a most disturbing sound.
Place is amazing.
My name is Charles Lindbergh, and I flew across the Atlantic Ocean.
Yeah, it's a really nice little speakeasy, but, you know.
Currently, I'm working as a U.S. airmail pilot.
Just keep it on down low, because I can't have any more scandal going around with my already numerous scandals. It's a rough time for me and my presidency, because a lot of scandals, like the Teacot Dome scandal, and, you know, members of the Ohio gang.
My great-grandma was a Pelican.
So, by the way, I'm meaning to ask you, how was the trip across the Atlantic?
Oh, it was great.
So, like, no need for no plane. It's just flat. Sailing. Through the airwaves.
But, you know, the one good thing that did come out of my presidency, if I didn't say so, was the disarmament of the world powers, the Washington Naval Conference. We convinced some of the world powers to get rid of part of their army and navy, sorry, not army. Not make any warships for the next 10 years.
Welcome to Club 452.
How you doing, man? It's a pleasure.
Oh yeah. George Gershwin.
Charles Lindbergh. Fun establishment you have here.
Sure, I already shook my hand, all right, everything.
Alright.
I was born in Brooklyn in 1898, and my parents moved to America from Ukraine, from a city called Odessa, where they changed their name from Gershowitz to Gershwin for lack of using it to become an easier name to pronounce.
So, beautiful place you got here.
I was one of four children.
Yeah,
not too loud, sir. In the next year, my parents bought my brother Ira a piano, gave him some piano lessons. I began playing. We kind of became partners as the years went by. So. And then in 1924, I wrote Rhapsody in Blue, one of my most famous pieces. Shortly after, I went to Paris.
Sorry.
All right, so we've got Louis Armstrong on the trumpet tonight with the band.
The only thing I didn't like is people called me Louis. Don't like Louis. You know, got my start in New Orleans. Kinda, you know, made myself famous around there. pretty common, actually, for a person of color to be performing. But not so much interacting with the people at the clubs.
And my musical interest sort of started when I was 10 years old, when I went to visit my friend at his violin recital, which is where I really just started to appreciate music. My mentor, we were always in touch. We practically,
my real father wasn't the stay-at-home kind of guy.
And I'll be playing keys. Here we have Al Capone with one of his men.
All right, I'm Al Capone. I was born in Brooklyn in 1899, and I'm a Big Shot gangsta.
Well, I had a lot of people close to me who betrayed me, and
I've been in gangs since I was 14 and got kicked out of school.
Oh, Mr. Capone. Glad to see you're still supplying the stuff for this place.
I've been hooking up my boys in New York, helping them get their drink on, smuggling some liquor. Ain't no thing.
Oh, I don't know what you're talking about, Mr. President.
Ah, you never do, do you?
All this booze, man!
Trade my trust.
All this booze! People in New York are desperate for their smuggled liquors. They'll pay any price, man. Any price.
Mrs. Delaney, if you don't mind, come back.
That's great. Nice shot.
Thank you.
Nice
Mr.
shot.
Not so great.
All right, wait. This isn't for like the public eye or anything, right? In confidence? Yeah?
Yeah, sure.
Cool.
What were the 20s like for you?
You Harlem Renaissance. Well, my name's Richard Delaney, but you can't call me Richard.
Mr. Delaney is a good man.
Prohibition? Movies, flappers, bootleggers.
One of my best workers.
You can just call me Delaney, okay?
A lot of faith in that dude.
January 1st, actually, 1920. My wife, Shadynasty, got hit by the Model T.
Mr. President, would you care to play a game?
I think I can play a game right now.
Mrs. Delaney, you can sit this one out.
I'll be going. I work for Al Capone.
In my control.
So, I was in Chicago last week.
Oh, were you?
Yeah, your handiwork was all over the place.
I just can't prove anything, just to bust him.
Well, better watch out, the FBI's got some new leads. Well,
I actually, all my accounting seems to be in order at the moment. And
I just thought I'd warn you, I don't think I'll be president very much longer because all my scandals.
Played the trumpet. Moved around, bands, clubs, dancing. But, you know, people of color weren't really meant to interact with the others at the clubs. We were almost toys, like playthings, like going to a zoo, watching monkeys. I don't think it's right.
I've recently been told that one of my trusted associates is illegally selling oil. It was the government's and for the Navy.
Seems
not too
like...
happy about that.
Seems like your friends are turning into your enemies.
Well, I mean, you can only trust a good friend, right?
So have you always wanted to be an aviator and flying around, stuff like that?
Actually, no. I was, for a while, I was in Wisconsin studying engineering, and I figured that aviation...
It's the president! Scratch!
Fit for me, and I, it was more exciting.
Mr. Delaney. Sorry, stay out here, Mr. Delaney.
Thank you. Mr. Delaney, yeah, if you wouldn't mind, we have some business to take care of.
Hey, close the door behind you, Miss Armstrong.
Wait, maybe I could just come in for a minute?
No. So, President Harding, tell us a little bit about your roots and what.
Well, you know, at first I wasn't really into politics, but people started telling me, you know, you look like a president. You look like you'd be a good president. I thought, you know, after the war, we need to return to normal. We need normalcy. So I ran for president. Look how that turned out.
Mr. Valentino is going to be here any minute.
He should be here any minute.
Oh. Hello, gentlemen.
Ah, Mr. Valentino.
How are you?
Right on time.
Ah, there
My name is Rudolph Valentino. I was born in Italy. My full name is Rodolfo Alfonso Raffaello Pierre Filiberto Guglielmo de Valencia da Angostella. You can see why I went by just Rudolph Valentino in my career to the United States. Ellis Island. I was 18 years old, December 23rd. I remember that day, like it was flat broke. I just had no money. I was bussing tables, didn't work. For a while, I was a taxi dancer.
I'm all done tending to the lonely women of Manhattan.
Now what that is I dance with women at clubs who don't have anyone to dance with. They pay me money.
So I can spend it on alcohol.
Valentino, movie star.
I was in silent movies. Those were the new craze. I took advantage of that. It was great. My most famous movie is The Sheik. Really great picture. Son of the Sheik. The Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse.
Valentino, yeah, he my boy. I've seen all his movies. Talent.
Mr. President.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Miss Lindbergh, there you go.
Thank you very much, sir.
The invitation is too dark for me to be able to pass. Mr. Valentino.
Thank you.
You are.
I'm a movie star after all.
Thank you, thank you, Mr. Capone.
Sure.
A toast
to the 20s. This stuff is very strong. You guys have anywhere we can just sit down, maybe congregate?
Oh man, all right, let's head back into there. Sorry. That's okay. The absinthe. It's very absinthe. After you, sir.
Yep.
God, okay. This presidency is such a mess. I don't know who I can trust nowadays.
This is such the life.
I wonder why my wife hasn't written back to me yet. I had a Jean Acker. I totally fell in love with her because I was seeking companionship after my mother died. What I later found out was that she was in fact a lesbian. As soon as we got married, she kicked me out.
I wonder what else should I do? Maybe I'll write a book about my flight.
Rhapsody in Blue. In 1924, I wrote Rhapsody in Blue, one of my most famous pieces. Shortly after, I went to Paris, studied there, and when I came back, I wrote my next piece called An American in Paris. Appropriate, I think so. I got a lot of mixed reviews. And now, me and my brother Ira are working on hopefully our next big hit on Broadway called Porgy and Bess.
Wish I was in New Orleans.
The Age of Jazz. Kind of the lead guy for that, you know, got my start in New Orleans, kind of, you know, made myself famous around there.
This is the police! Guys, there's the booze!
I'll take care of this.
Can I help you, sir?
Have you seen this man? He's wanted for tax evasion.
No, I haven't seen that man. You can have a look around if you'd like.
I would like a look around, please, very much.
As you can see, there's nothing to see here. As you can tell, there's nothing to see here. So, Oh, and if anyone asks, I wasn't here.
Golly gee, a whole dollar! It's what I always wanted. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Have a good night.
Trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more. And I never knew, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.